I had a very interesting experience of working with Professor Ravi Mathai, particularly as a member of the Education Systems Group at the Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad, between 1973 when I joined and till 1994 when Ravi Mathai died. Once we were camping in Jawaja near Byawar in Ajmer district, we used to go there quite frequently and stay in the Jawaja Dak Bungalow. In the summer of 1976 May, in one of my trips, I took my family with me, my wife and my son and daughter. They were 4 or 5 years old at the time, and Ravi came from Delhi. He apparently went for a meeting of the Board of Escorts, and then he got with him two very interesting models of escort tractors. And when he saw my kids, he passed these on to them, and they say, and said that play with them. So I asked Ravi, how come you got these toy looking models of the tractors? And he said he was coming on the board meeting at Escorts. And then he went on to talk of the various boards on which he was. And we had many conversations later, and what I learned from Ravi was, when he was the director of IIM Ahmedabad, he looked at each board member as a resource. And he started planning and using, making use of each board member. For example, he used to tell me, for raising funds, he would go to some of the board members who are from the private sector and get them to be involved and fund, give funds for the institute. And when the funding has reached a particular level, he would go to the government members that are represented on the board and request them to match the grant and so on. That is the way he raised finances. Same way, I think when the private sector and the kind of experience Ravi had at a very young age, knowing quite a lot about industry organizations, they used to, being a director of IIM Ahmedabad, used to ask him to be on the board. And when he was on the board of various companies, He not only got these companies to visit the Institute for Placement, employing people, and I'm sure most people would know that in those days, in mid-60s, management is not yet considered as a great field. And the MBAs had to be sold. In fact, Ravi once said, I used to go with a begging bowl to ask companies to employ the students. And that is the way he used to do that. So he used to sell both the students as well as the faculty to the corporations on which he was on the board. I still remember the way, I think, Bharat Atomworks, and for that matter, I'm sure many companies on which he was associated did this. In Bharat Atomworks, to the extent I recollect, he was responsible for getting Professor S.K. Bhattacharya to do their long-term planning. Apparently, in one of the board meetings, the board of Bharat Atomworks was thinking about diversification, etc., etc., and Ravi said that you should think big. And when the chairman asked him, I think that time the chairman was on General Money, when he asked him, he said, I would send one of my faculty to have a look at, I think, your company and look at business opportunities and help you to work out a long-term plan. That is when S.K. Bhattacharya came into picture, and most of the people would know it was S.K. Bhattacharya's recommendations that got Bharat Atomworks to plan much ahead. In almost about 7-8 years time, from 70 crores, they moved to about 700-800 crore turnover. And that was what was responsible for even Uday Parikh and me to be associated with Bharat Atomworks, develop the HRD systems for them and so on. So Ravi would take help from each of the board member because he treated them as a resource. I still remember immediately after Ravi stepped aside as director and Paul took over, I joined during Paul's time. Every time there was a board meeting, there used to be either a lunch or a dinner with both the board as well as the society members and all the faculty. And I remember not once but more than once Professor Paul introducing me to some of the board or society members and talking about, of course, the rest of it is my own initiative in terms of telling them what I was doing, the work, etc. So I think it's a good practice to get the board and the society, and whatever boards you have, to interact with the faculty as well as the students. Of course, Professor Mathai used to tell me it is there after he stepped aside as director, a large part of his time he was spending to fulfill the obligations he had during the time he was director and representing IIM on the boards. I have seen it very recently when Ahmedabad Management Association, since I'm on the governing council of the Ahmedabad Management Association, asked me to do a workshop, a 4-hour workshop on HR. I got 4 speakers, and for each speaker, to get them to speak, I had to give something in return. For one of them, I promised whenever you ask me to give webinars, I will give. So I think it's always a give and take. And if you know how to use the board members, they can do a hell of a lot in terms of putting you in touch with the environment, creating placement opportunities. But they should know the kind of work that you're doing, and that is where it helps. So if you have, let us say, 20 board members, even if you get about half a dozen of them agree to meet the faculty on a particular day, you can declare a particular day as an interaction day with board, and then keep it in small groups. You can have, if you have 500 students, divide 500 of them into batches of 50 each, then you have 10 board members addressing each one separately, and get each section or a representative from each of the group to get together later and tell them what they have learned from this particular board member. That gives an opportunity for the board members to know about the students, or know later on about the faculty, or lecture to the faculty. I think once a year, a talk by at least the select board members to the faculty will tell the faculty about the things that are going on in the minds of, let's say, some of the board members, because they represent very good corporations. Some of them are representing financial and banking institutions. Some of them are civil servants. Some of them are representing certain communities and groups. Some of them are big industrialists and so on. So what a resource the board brings. But normally some of the directors who are fearful of the board and who treat their job as having to manage the board, I think are unconsciously preventing the community, the stakeholders, particularly the students and faculty, from getting benefit of the presence of the boards. Most of the board members, you only need to talk, they are more than eager to share their experiences. I am myself surprised. I am on the board of a few institutions. I find that those institutions with which I am not associated as a board member are more interested in using my expertise than those institutions on whose board I am. For example, in the last couple of months, I am teaching in 4 different institutions, including IIM, and just now committed to take a session with the students of XLRI, Jamshedpur, and so on. But if I look back of those other institutions where I am on the board, I think they will only wait for my presence in the board meeting, and they will send me the board agenda, and they will ask me maybe a few governance questions like faculty evaluation, etc., etc., and so on. I think it's a very pathetic underutilization of the board members' expertise and time. So friends, I think through this video, I would like to communicate to all the academic institutions. I think if you are a professor, insist on your director to have at least once a year meeting with the board members. If you are a student, I mean, nothing prevents you from getting in touch with board members. You conduct so many of the seminars, workshops, conferences. They're all student organized. I think involve them. I still remember for long years, whenever we had an executive development program in IIM, one of the local board members used to be invited. Or for inauguration of the postgraduate program, we would have one of the board members come and inaugurate, share their experience and things like that. I think this is the way the board members can be involved. If they don't like, if they are too busy people, if they are not available, I'm sure after denying at least 4 times, the 5th time the board members would say, yeah, I would like to come. And meet the students or faculty and so on. So I think this entire video is meant to inspire the directors of institutions and the deans and the faculty and students to make use of their board members, because they represent a lot of expertise, a lot of resource, a lot of intellectual capital, and you don't need to keep on searching for intellectual capital elsewhere. when you have it on your own boats. All the best from TVRLS.